There's new JSON functionality now available in Azure SQL Database. Learn how you can use it, and it just works faster. This week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Yusi, a Principal Program Manager on the SQL team. Thanks so much for joining us.
Yeah, thanks, Anna.
Excited to have you. And today we're going to be talking about some new announcements that recently landed in Azure SQL Database in the JSON space.
Yep.
Now, maybe before we get into it, I know we support JSON somehow today.
Yes.
What's different with this announcement?
Yeah, great. Yeah, today you can store JSON documents in a string. So you have any character string column, you can store the JSON document as a string. And then you can parse the JSON document, search for properties in the JSON document. So that's what we have today.
Okay.
But the problem is every time you search, we have to go parse the entire document and find where a particular key or a property is. So now we are going to add a new binary data type, which basically stores it in a more compact and easy to query format. So that's one of the
cool
big benefits is now you'll have a type called JSON.
Okay, cool. And it's more performant. So basically what you're saying is I don't have to go character by character. I can
yep.
just use normal JSON stuff the way it works and
yeah.
it'll just work.
Yeah. I mean, basically every time you search for a key, we don't have to go and look at the entire document. Instead, we can go look up the property. It's similar to looking up an index, a value in an index.
Awesome. Cool.
So that's what we have
so
today.
So what else do I want to know about this? What else should folks know?
Well, this one, let me show you what I have here today in terms of usage, right? So here is an example of a table where you now have a new type called JSON. I mean, it's also part of the ANSI SQL standard now, and that's what we are doing today. And you insert JSON documents as a string, just like today. There's no difference. And once you have it, it's just a string. But the only difference is the engine will store it in a binary format. And later, you can query individual properties out of the JSON document. And here is an example where these are existing functions like JSON value, which basically extracts a single property out of the JSON document. And it works seamlessly. And the main difference is it's going to be faster.
Awesome. We like faster with no change. So
that's...
I don't have to change my code the way I was working with JSON before.
No, you just change your data type in the column to JSON, and then you're good to go.
Cool, nice. Now, what if I was working with a bunch of rows of data and I wanted to use them or convert them to JSON or backwards or any differences in that?
Yes. So currently we have what is called a for JSON operator, which is what you would use. But it's not like a declarative syntax. So if you want to use it with aggregates or do very complex shapes of JSON documents, it's kind of hard to use.
Okay.
So in SQL Server 2022, we added some functions like JSON object and JSON array. And now we are adding the aggregate version of it. So let me show a quick example of how that would look. So here in this table, you can see there's like accounts data and some order data. And often customers want to transform this and produce basically JSON document for the applications. So here, now you can run the JSON aggregates and get the result as a single JSON document.
Nice.
This is the other big benefit of the new functionality.
That's awesome. Cool. And so as folks get started with this, do you have any tips or tricks, or do they have to do anything special to get this?
No, it's a public preview, so it's just available in any database in SQL DB at the moment.
Okay, so even if I have an existing Azure SQL database?
Yeah, you can just use it.
It.
There's nothing to do.
Awesome, cool. Okay, well, Yusi, thanks so much for coming on the show. I learned a lot. I'm sure our viewers learned a lot as well. If you like this episode, go ahead, give it a like, leave us a comment, and let us know what you think of this new functionality. We'll also put some links in the description for you to learn more. We hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.